Hello, welcome back to Let's Play Torment, Tides of Numenera. Finally, heading through the path to the Resonance. In search of the changing god and... yeah, the sorrow and... I think we left the sorrow behind. At least for now, I'm sure. It's going to show up again. We're going. A pleasant wooded area with steps. Doesn't sound so pleasant now, does it? Destroy them! Erase them in the name of our sire! Couldn't take any actions, huh? Rima Siro. The glaive you met in Milavest stares at you with wild fury and no sense of recognition, as though you were her most hated enemy. Another one? You've come too late to help the traitors. Kill her, too. It's another illusion. You're trapped in an illusion, Rima. None of this is real. Gold Tide raised a moderate amount, and Blue Tide a small amount. Deceitful as the first herself, my mind is clear, and I see you for the avaricious liar you are. Very good vocabulary. Defeat Rima or find a way to free her from the labyrinth's illusion. Okay, it's come to this. Changing God's Peltast? What's a Peltast? Okay, so we can also interact with this thing. I don't know what that is. Endless Battle Fathom. Oh, that makes sense. As you approach the crystals, their facets twinkle in the moonlight. Slow pulses of aquamarine light radiate from the center, the pattern's even repetition instilling a remarkable sense of clarity. The fabrications of the labyrinth become crystal clear the closer you come to the crystals. What's more, you can feel the weight of energy inside the crystals trying to escape. There's power here, if you can release it. All right. Smash open the crystals to release their energy. And go to 80. Critical success. I got all this effort restored. Or actually it wasn't taken away in the first place, I guess. The blow creates hairline fissures in the surface. The pulsing continues unabated, but the crystal's tensile strength can't hold against many more strikes like that. Okay, Eritus. We're all gonna smash this thing. The crystals continue to radiate light in gentle, consistent pulses. Standing so close sharpens your perception of the labyrinth around you, revealing its truth. Smash open the weakened crystals. We can get to 100% with our good friend Eritus. Another blow and the hairline fissures become large cracks. Reaching your fingers into the thin gaps, the glass is cool to the touch. You brace a foot on a stone curb and pull back. With a sharp snap, a small piece of the crystal tears open. A blue pearl lies embedded in the ground beneath it. The energy from the pearl presses against your mind, aching to escape. Alright. The pearl.
Fine.
Crush the pearl and release its energy. 100% I can get. Your boot compresses the pearl until it bursts with a liquid pop. A wave of cool light flows out in all directions. For a moment, your senses heighten. Sounds clearer, vision sharper. Beyond anything you've experienced before. Immediately, the others are freed from their illusion and begin to fade, their consciousness disappearing elsewhere into the labyrinth. All except for Rima, who seems to recognize you as her mind clears. Yay, we didn't have to fight her. What happened? You're the one from Milavest. I'll help you as best I can.
I feel better.
Feel better, huh? Okay. She's gonna help us. Who's over here? Oh, Rima's right there. Anything else to see here? Let's expand this way first. Nope. It's up there. Alright, let's talk to Rima. Too bad we can't search these bodies. Thank you for freeing me from the grip of this place. Yeah, not a problem. Glad you didn't kill me. Looks like there's a path beyond all this crap.
I'm going.
We're going. Oh my. Gonna be another battle, isn't it? Sorry guys, I know it's lame to keep saving in the middle, but getting to the end battle here. Just make sure it's still there. I always do that. It's probably getting slow because I have so many saves.
Sure enough.
It's the agents of the Coward Sire. Hold the line. Remember the Nano's fate and avoid the pylons. Defeat Free or incapacitate Andronus' squad. Alright, I'm going to use the pillars. Andronus Sandhand. Oh, here's Zarian Daywalker. Two members of the First Militia. And looks like that's it. And then we continue west or something. Let's see.
Sure enough.
This strange machine vibrates, humming almost below the register you can hear. Every few seconds, the air around it ripples, and an arc of energy spits across the space between this pylon and the enormous tower nearby. A small control panel glows inside of the machine. Try to activate the pylon. Hopefully we're doing the right thing. The controls are not hard to figure out. Within moments, the air around the pylon begins to ripple, and an arc of energy connects it to the other machines nearby. The machine's humming increases. As you step away from the controls, the pylon's power begins to fade. The knob you turn to activate is slowly turning back by itself. It's only a matter of time before the pylon powers down again. I'm hoping the purpose of these things is to disrupt the illusion. Alright, let's see if we can activate other pylons.
Look out, villains! Trouble coming your way!
You can't. As before, the machine hums at some ultra-low frequency. A small control panel glows in its side. Frost perch. Ow. I would advise you not to attack us, sirs. Well, let's see if we can activate this one.
I'm ready.
I'm at least 6 times better than I was seconds ago.
A small control panel glows in its side. The air around the pylon ripples, and an arc of energy connects it to the machines nearby. Almost immediately, it begins gradually powering down. Is the other one still powered? How many pylons are there? How many turns do I have until it's gone? And what is that, a pylon? It looks different. Well, maybe this one's already on. It looks like it is. Let's see if I can mess with it. This Castoff is trapped in some kind of stasis. The energy field seems linked to the enormous machine next to him. Oh. Well, we only have one pylon. Can Calistese get to it? It looks like she can. Activate. With all three pylons activated, the massive tower pounds the air. Every Castoff caught within the web of energy, those still under the labyrinth's illusions, suddenly freezes in place. Stasis field.
Can't say I mind that.
Why are we back down to Rima? Oh, is that what we're gonna do? Oh, wait. Who's this? Oh, that's Andronas. He ran over there. Okay, so do we just leave then? The first militia is over here. It's over, Paj. We have the Reconciler of Truth. Surrender, and I won't have to destroy you. This isn't the endless battle, brother. Just an illusion. There's nothing beyond the door but the first. I will get to her. You! As if I didn't have enough trouble. Where they let us read. So many times in playing games like this, you have time to read it. You know, in your mind, just not out loud. Defeat the Chalcedon and Paj Rekkon, or find a way to open the cave door. How about... Oh, yeah, Paj Rekkon. How about open the cave door instead? Which basically just means running past all these people.
Fair enough.
And then they'll all attack.
Barely making a
stretch. What about that? There's something there. You can touch that. And we can... Well, let's examine. Glowing petroglyphs portray the myth of the endless battle from the local population's perspective. Two gods met in battle, laying waste to the nearby villages without any sign the Titans noticed. Alright. I guess I just have to mess with this. He can't make it very far at all. We're basically all gonna attack him.
You want a job done right.
Then run through your enemies. Well, he's strong. They're all gonna go on him.
Barely making a stretch.
Okay, maybe not. I can get all the way up to the door. But I can't affect it. This is my action and move.
Nothing can stop me now.
Cause I'm the Duke of Okay. Now they're all gonna attack us. Oh, they're attacking each other. Well, better than us, I guess.
Barely making a scratch.
Oh, crap.
Never felt better than I do right now.
Somehow I doubt that. Oh, Rima's coming. Is that why it went down to her? Could we have asked her for help? And she would have followed us? Help the guy out. Actually... It's not my turn. Yeah. Gonna help him.
No.
I prefer to heal if I can. Because I heal for more. The last Castoff does, but it's not my turn right now. Can he do this? Strips of citrine. Yeah, you can't take the action. Strips of citrine light under a transparent casing crisscross the rough-hewn stone door in front of you. They meet in the center, their energy flows merging, binding the door shut tight. So we could tear off the strong glass panels covering the yellow light with smashing and quick fingers, but we don't have an action right now. What about this guy?
Look out below.
He can do it.
Sideways.
Tear off the strong glass panels covering the yellow light. 90%. Wriggling your fingers under the edge of the strong glass, you manage to yank the covering free of the door. As soon as it is connected, the nearly unbreakable material crumbles to dust. The stream of flaxen light continues flowing, unbroken, holding the door closed. Searing heat emanates from the exposed beam. Uh-oh.
Feels like someone threw up in my
mouth. Ew. That's pretty disgusting. I want to help him, but we need to get this door open. The cyclopean stones of the door continue glowing with yellow hashes. Okay. So endurance, concentration, hold your hand in the exposed light and try to disrupt it, or lure machinery and mystical. Figure out another way to disrupt the beam. I'm going to hold my hand in the exposed light and try to disrupt it. Just 100%, we can go. That used up might pool. That's cool. I don't use might pool that much, so... Carefully, you reach your hand into the gap between the doors. Blisters immediately begin forming on your skin, causing 4 damage to your health pool, seared by the coruscating light. A few tears trickle down your face, but you manage to hold still. Just as you think you can't resist any longer, the energy sputters and flares, then dies. The covalent bond is broken, revealing a heavy but crude mechanical lock underneath. I can still go, so I can... That's better, so we can serve as meat shield some more. Alright, Calistige. The light flowing across the stone doors has faded, but the gate remains held shut. How good is she at this? Quick fingers and perception. Pick the mechanical lock. 80%. Yay! You deftly lift the pins inside the cast iron lock. There's a satisfying click, and the doors open of their own accord. Okay. Finally, I won't waste any more time with you lot. Are they just gonna leave through the door? Enter the cave. Okay. We're entering through the cave then. Oh no no, allow me. Hello? Where are we now? I said no. How many more times do I have to say it? Only until you change your mind. Only until you say yes. Oh, the first fathom. All these fathoms. It goes... this is the changing gods machine. Wow. It's not closed until I accept that. Something. A decision that I'm coming to regret. The answer is still no. Oh, that's the changing god. And the first. Is this an illusion too? What I ask is not so great, is it? You ask for my deepest secrets. Is that not great? Compared to my life in a rotting shell? Everyone lives in a rotting shell. Surely you're not so selfish that you can't see that. This is an interesting conversation. Except now they're just repeating themselves. I like that. Poof! There is no door or a portal back to the fathom you came from, only a diffused light with no discernible source. These mushrooms are reacting... You're mistaken, Marilel. I do care. These mushrooms are reacting to the pulses of the rings. A sharp... I care for my peace of mind. I care for my creations. I care for my future. You threaten them all. Sorry, I'm just reading these because I know they go away. What does it say about the mushrooms? A sharp citrus scent fills the air each time their spores burst forth. Intense cold rolls... You know my tenacity. You gave it to me. It's not closed until I accept that. A decision I'm coming to regret. That's what we missed before. The answer is still no. Intense cold rolls over you with each burst of light. Presumably this machine was something of your sire's, constructed from cast-off memories. Oh, we can level up. Let's do that. There's two of us can. Alright. We're gonna be leveled up. Let's be leveled up. What do you think? I have so much intelligence. How about speed? Okay, so we reached tier 6. We know resourceful. We know energized. Scanning array. 5% bonus for each level of effort applied to perception or any of the lore tasks. It's only 5% though. Successive attack, a bonus attack when you kill an enemy. I don't know if we're going to be killing anybody at this point. Charm. Automatically succeed on the next persuasion, deception, or intimidation task. 1 of 1 uses per day remaining. So I have to use charm and then do the task. Quantum step. This is teleportation. Entropic field. Calisthenes has that. Calisthenes has gravity manipulation as well. Pulling someone around. Hedge magic. Automatically succeed on the next quick fingers or smashing task. You snap your fingers and knots untangle themselves. Doors pop open. Chests unlock. It's easy if you know how to do it. Quick fingers or smashing task. Okay. We've used these, you know, it's too bad I didn't have it before. I mean, we succeeded anyway. But then I wouldn't have to put any effort towards it, right? I could have saved that effort. But we're okay with effort anyway. I'm kind of leaning on this. I mean, I don't know what we're going to need here at the end of the game. Hedge magic. Data sphere link. +1 training level in all the 3 lore skills. Unstoppable force. +2 damage on esoteric attacks. Only +2. Plague spirits. Critical hits, confers disrupted. It's only for critical hits. Scatter bomb. Attack all enemies in range. Let's use a speed instead, dealing 4 energy damage. Any enemies with negative fettles that you are hit are also pushed away a short distance. +1 damage per effort applied to a max of +7. Oh, I get +0% on attacks. Great. You summon the energy from the very air around you, drawing strength and power in massive quantities, and then you release it in a great wave. It's only 4 energy damage. I'm gonna take hedge magic. Well, I get 2. Okay. I'm already maxed out. Well, I'm maxed out in lore machinery, but not mystical or natural. So, hedge magic and data sphere link. Look at that. Training level. Oh, look, specialized. Wait. Specialized? I got specialized plus. Can I get more info on that? +15 bonus per level on difficult tasks. Specialized plus. It doesn't say that, well... Yeah. I can't get any more information on this stuff. Like, what does plus mean? It should have more of a bonus per level on difficult tasks. Because it looks the same as the mystical and the natural. which were at 1. I don't know. Well, at least I got, you know, I'm specialized in all lore. We are the lore master, not the lore runner. That's already taken. Gonna be the lore master. Yes, child. Extra effort, I'll do. Okay, now let me see. Before I interrupt, idyllic scene. Still on 135. So should we talk to the Endless God or Marilel? Let's talk to Marilel. Hello? You have walked into the middle of an argument. As I realize that. Neither of the speakers acknowledges your presence. Their concentration is fully engaged with the other. One of them looks like Andronus, the cast-off from Mila Vest, but he carries himself very differently. Confident. Haughty. This must be Andronus before he was cast off. It looks like Andronus? Well, it says he's the changing god. The other is the first cast-off as you saw her in the Memavira's fortress, but noticeably less scarred and beaten. A younger version. No, Marilel. Andronus, or rather the changing god, says, I gave you my reasons, and I have had enough of explaining myself to you. Her eyes burn through the blank stare of her porcelain mask. I have aided you in your researches. Uncovered secrets of the tides you never knew, would never have figured on your own. I'm twice the thinker you... You're an accident. I won't deny the advantages your awareness provides, but do not deign to suggest we are anything like equals. The first thoughts are jumbled and confused. Her mind is in a loop, reliving the same moments over and over again. If I say nothing, are they just gonna... He shrugs, supremely uninterested in her reaction. You're a part of me that's forgotten itself. You'll see. When I gather you back, all of you, and restore my daughter, then everything will be clear. You'll have that new body. Mine. He frowns. But right now, Marilel, you're interrupting me. You're distracting me from my work. Who's his daughter? Oh, look at that. I just noticed... Oh, it's a ring. Never mind. I thought I was looking at some worm or intestine thing. I've become so used to the bloom that, yeah, everything looks kind of disgusting. Her voice, heavy with frustration, fraught and pleading. They call you a god, but your divinity is a joke. You lied to me. You never intended to get me a new body, did you? You were going to let me help you as long as you needed, and then you were going to cast me aside. It's like you cast my body aside when you were done with it. And for what? You have a daughter? The first cast-off snarls. You have a daughter. Right here. The one you're talking about has been dead for centuries. But I am flesh and blood. I am alive and begging for your help to stay that way. Okay, so the first cast-off is real. And she's going through this illusion. The changing god is not really there. At least that's the way it seems. That's the way everything else has been going in these fathoms. But he's here somewhere. The changing god is in here in my mind. The look of empathy and compassion has disappeared from his face. You're not my daughter. You're a creation. You're a shell. Do you feel shame when you discard your old clothes? Do you feel pity when a doll burns? He points at her face. I feel as much connection to you as I do that mask. I don't hate you, Marilel. His tone softens. I don't despise you, but you need to look at this from my perspective. He gestures around. All of this equipment, all of the cast-offs, they're all just byproducts of what I began long ago. I must finish what I started. I need a drink. See, when we talk... She thinks what we're saying is coming from him. How will you finish what you started? How will you finish what you started? She whispers. The sorrow hunts us because of what you've done. I know that. Gods! He rubs his fingers angrily over his head. The sorrow is an unfortunate byproduct of my work. You know that. So my solution is simple. I'm going to find a way to bring you all back into myself. My mind will be whole again, and whatever evil the sorrow thinks I've done will be put to rest. It will leave us alone forever. Not us. You. If you suck us into your head, we will no longer exist. She shakes her head. I won't let you. We will find another way. He laughs, not scornfully, but as if she said something genuinely hilarious. How? How will you find a solution that has eluded me? By definition, you cannot. Oh, we have a lot of choices here. there's the three ones that were there before. I don't care what you think. This life is mine. I will choose how to live it. Are we deciding what she's going to say now? My body is in the bloom. This is all an illusion. I won't be part of it anymore. Your last Castoff believes in what I'm doing. I no longer need your approval. You're right. We're just pieces of your mind. I'm sorry I ever doubted you. Or just walk away. Very curious about this one. I'm not sure if there's any right or wrong answer here, guys. Your last Castoff believes in what I'm doing. I no longer need your approval. Gold tide raises a small amount. Your last Castoff believes in what I'm doing, she says, though it's clear from her expression that she doesn't understand the words coming from her mouth. I no longer need your approval.
I'm ready to learn something new.
Nice. We're leveling up a lot here. This reminds me of the end of Planescape Torment, when, like, you get something that gives you, like, 50,000 experience. It's like a million experience or some crazy number like that. She blinks several times, her eyes suddenly clear. The illusion is shattered. She startles and gapes at you. The changing god's avatar dissolves into dust and memory, as if it had never existed at all. A portal opens where he stood, beckoning you further into the labyrinth. Its grasp is undeniable. Stuff. The first Castoff crosses her arms and regards you quietly for a moment. Why did you choose to save me from that? It was the right thing to do. Gold tide? Yeah. Small amount. She seems unconvinced. Well, I appreciate your thoughtfulness, but it doesn't change anything. Then she turns abruptly and strides to the portal. Without turning around, she says, "Thank you." Then, in a brief flicker of light, she's gone. Hey! Get back here! I say get back here! Hey! Okay. She's gone. This goes where? It doesn't say. That's covering it. They're not telling us this time. We've examined all this stuff. You guys have anything new to say?
Try not to think so hard. I think you're giving me a headache.
Tell me where to step. I don't want to kick over your memories.
Okay. Looks like a good place to cut it off here and go into wherever the hell that goes. Actually, no. Wait one second.
Here.
I'm going to level up, so if you guys want to skip this, it's just leveling up. And we're going to sign off. Ability or skill? These are the skills. Some of these are good choices. Well, this increases our healing. That might be useful. Or anamnesis. Or... yeah, let's increase an ability. I think I can only do one, right? Oh, not ability. Sorry. Skill. I'll increase my healing even more. I'd do anamnesis if I could. Tyvir? You can increase feint or issue challenge, which I really don't use. So how about skill? We just leveled him up too. How about healing, so when he uses his items? For all I know, we don't have to heal anymore. How should I know? Yeah. Healing. I can only do one. Yep. Calisthes, is right behind us. Eretus. Extra effort. Yes. And he's saying something that we can't hear. Alright, now done. Now ready to go through. Thanks so much for watching, guys. See you in the next episode. And endure. In enduring, grow strong.